Welcome to the Introduction to and Regulation of Community-Based Living Arrangements from the Nevada Department of Health and Human Services. This is the first module in a series of training courses you must take to get certification as a CBLA provider from the State Bureau of Healthcare Quality and Compliance. So what are Community-Based Living Arrangement Services, or for short, CBLA services? Well, in 2017, the Nevada Legislature passed Assembly Bill 46, and in Section 4, Chapter 269 of that act, CBLAs are defined as flexible, individualized services, including, without limitation, training and habilitation services that are provided in the home for compensation to persons with mental illness or persons with related conditions who are served by the Division of Public and Behavioral Health or by any other entity, and designed and coordinated to assist such persons in maximizing their independence. When a law is passed, state officials write regulations to provide specific guidance to both the public and to government employees about what can be done under that law and how the law will be enforced. Those regulations are called the Nevada Administrative Code, or NAC. And for community-based living arrangements, the enforcement of the law is the job of the Bureau of Healthcare Quality and Compliance, a program of the Department of Health and Human Services. The regulations regarding CBLAs are approved by the Nevada State Board of Health after a thorough public review process, and they took effect July 1, 2017. The State Board of Health considers and approves regulations regarding many health-related issues. This includes the standards for the provision of quality care by a provider of services, and the requirements for the issuance and renewal of a certificate. As this applies to you, certificate means a certificate that authorizes a natural person or entity to provide services, and that certificate is issued by the Division of Public and Behavioral Health, which regulates CBLAs through the Bureau of Healthcare Quality and Compliance. Of course, the natural person or entity that wishes to provide CBLA services is you. As a community-based living arrangement provider, you will be working extensively with the staff of the Bureau of Healthcare Quality and Compliance, also known as HCQC. It is HCQC's mission to provide health, life safety, and environmental inspection services, certification requirements, and enforcement oversight over community-based living arrangement services in the state of Nevada. From its offices in Carson City and Las Vegas, HCQC employs a staff of highly trained professionals, including nurses, dietitians, social workers, medical laboratory technologists, and specialists in environmental and food safety, building and fire, child care development, and more. In addition to certifying and inspecting CBLA providers throughout Nevada, HCQC licenses or certifies and inspects 1,400 health facilities statewide, more than 500 child care facilities statewide, and is responsible for 1,500 medical laboratories and more than 14,000 medical lab personnel. Specifically in your case, HCQC processes applications for CBLA certification, including the operation of a screening panel that reviews all applications and supporting documentation. After that review, HCQC will issue or deny a CBLA certificate or provisional certificate, will conduct quality assurance reviews through on-site inspections, renew certificates, and, if necessary, revoke CBLA certificates from providers who are not living up to the standards set forth in the Nevada Administrative Code that are designed to protect the health and well-being of the clients in your care. To provide some background on state monitoring of community-based living arrangement services, an audit in 2017 found there was inadequate monitoring of providers of these homes. They found unsanitary conditions, personal health and safety concerns, fire safety concerns, inadequate medication management and practices, and bleak living conditions in numerous homes in different parts of the state. The audit found that inadequate inspections allowed CBLA providers to neglect their homes, and even found that in some cases, children were at risk because they were also living in the homes. The audit found that the unacceptable situation within CBLAs was caused in part by questionable staffing practices, so the auditor made 7 recommendations, and 6 of those 7 recommendations involved the inspection process and how state inspectors should get tougher on enforcing standards. That made the Bureau of Healthcare Quality and Compliance the natural fit to take over certification of CBLAs. The next few slides will show you what auditors found in some CBLA homes in Nevada. Squalid conditions in bathrooms and bedrooms, unsafe and inadequate bedrooms, improper storage of medications and inadequate food in the refrigerator, fire damage and hazards from improper disposal of cigarettes, and improper maintenance, just to name a few things. The auditors recommended that the state enact policies and procedures to make sure the clients receiving community-based living arrangement services are protected, similar to patients or clients of other health facilities inspected and licensed or certified by HCQC. Specifically, auditors said that the state should develop policies to ensure inspections are regularly and consistently performed, including regular staff training and monitoring by supervisors, and that items requiring corrective action be properly documented. They recommended that the state develop a standardized process for documenting and tracking implementation of corrective action items, that the state develop procedures for tracking corrective action items by provider and by home, including regular analysis to ensure corrective action is sustained, that the state develop policies and procedures for imposing sanctions when CBLA providers fail to meet standards. They recommended that the state develop policies and procedures regarding children living in CBLA homes, that officials develop policies and procedures regarding language proficiency and essential physical requirements for provider staff that regularly provide one-on-one services to clients. And their final recommendation was that the state develop policies and procedures to help ensure provider certification and that providers consistently and timely comply with recently enacted laws and regulations. Since HCQC has taken over, CBLAs will be inspected at least quarterly, that's every 3 months, or when there's a complaint. And except for first-time surveys on a new facility, all inspections are unannounced, meaning they'll just knock on the door without you knowing they're coming. Inspectors will have a checklist similar to the one you see here, and they'll go through the home, looking to make sure that everything is being maintained according to that checklist, identifying deficiencies or areas that are not meeting standards. As needed, inspectors will come back and conduct re-inspections, which a facility can either pass or fail, and which could lead to the revoking of a CBLA certificate. Repeat offenders are being tracked and will be looked at more closely to either bring them up to standard or close them down. Some of the standards that you'll need to maintain for your clients are a clean living environment, life safety standards such as working smoke detectors and carbon monoxide detectors, safe building conditions and no safety hazards either inside or on the exterior of the home. You'll need to keep a first aid kit and have emergency exit floor plans posted in several places in the home where clients and visitors both can see them clearly. Also on the inspector's checklists will be good lighting and privacy, clean bathrooms and personal hygiene products such as soap and towels, running hot and cold water, clean and working shower and bathing areas, clean and operational refrigerators, clean and operational kitchen stoves and food preparation counters, kitchen chairs and tables, operating washers and dryers, and clean furniture such as beds, couches, chairs, dressers, etc. HCQC inspectors will also check your home for life safety standards. This means you'll need to have working smoke detectors in every room and a working carbon monoxide detector. You'll need to maintain your structure so that it's safe, and you'll also need to remove any safety hazards you find. And you need to have floor plan diagrams posted throughout the house with emergency exits clearly marked in case of a fire or other reason to evacuate. You must keep a working and maintained fire extinguisher in the home at all times. It needs to be visible and easily accessible to anyone in the home, and so we recommend hanging it on the wall with brackets so that it stays in the same place all the time and people get used to it being there for that moment of panic when it's needed. Fire extinguishers need to be labeled with basic instructions on its use and need to be inspected yearly. The inspection record tag has the months on it and inspectors will check to see when it was last serviced. Some smoke detectors also serve as a carbon monoxide detector and we recommend you have at least one carbon monoxide detector in the home. Carbon monoxide is a colorless, odorless, tasteless, and potentially poisonous gas that can leak into your home from a stove, a clothes dryer, furnace, or other fuel-burning household appliance, or if a car motor is left running in a garage and it seeps into the house. Exposed wiring, both inside and outside the house, can be a safety hazard and must be fixed to protect people from touching it or keep it from sparking and starting a fire. Here you see a smoke detector that had some sort of defect and itself was a fire hazard. And you can even find exposed wiring from a garbage disposal under a sink where exposure to water adds to the danger. It was also improperly wired with a lamp cord and is missing a connection box cover. Our inspectors look up and down for exposed wiring, which they've seen coming from the ceiling where a light should be, or on the ground from a variety of sources. As you can see by all these different photos, exposed wiring can create a safety hazard in lots of different places around a house, and all of it needs to be fixed to cut down on fire hazards. When you buy or put together your first aid kit, make sure it is fully stocked. This graphic shows the items that should be in it, from various bandages to sterile gloves, tweezers, scissors to cut bandages, a cold pack, basic pain relievers, a thermometer, a face mask, antibacterial items, and you can even keep your flashlight with it. We just reviewed the supplies in your first aid kit, but that doesn't really help you if no one knows where it is. So that's why we've listed it first under the items for which you need to have a sign or obvious posting of where it's located. You should also have a sign for your fire extinguisher, visible floor plans with emergency escape routes, and even a sign with your cleaning schedule, which is in a way a safety measure. You also need to have a sign with emergency phone numbers, even put 911 on it, including phone numbers where you and other provider staff or caregiver staff can be reached, and include the hotline for the Bureau of Healthcare Quality and Compliance. You should also post the certificate if issued to you as a CBLA provider so that your residents and visitors, including other government agencies you might work with, can see it and know you're certified by the state to provide services to these clients. This is the end of the Community-Based Living Arrangement Overview Training Module. You may now return to the NV eLearn webpage for this module and take the quiz to test your knowledge. Once you've passed the quiz, a certificate of completion will be unlocked for you to print and download for submission with your CBLA application with the Bureau of Healthcare Quality and Compliance. You can then proceed to the rest of the training modules needed for your community-based living arrangement certification with the state of Nevada. Thank you.